Hi Unity family. Welcome to the fourth and final video in our colorful prayer series, where we explore coloring as a grounding exercise to quiet our minds and focus our attention on connecting with God. So far, we've colored our way through scripture meditation, praying for the world, and the daily examine. Since we celebrate Thanksgiving tomorrow, I think it's fitting to color our way through prayers of Thanksgiving with this last video and these last coloring sheets. Perhaps this can even be an activity that you do with your loved ones or alone, whether you're in person or remote tomorrow, or whatever your Thanksgiving might look like. Now, I don't know about you, but the act of giving thanks feels extra hard for me right now. It's been a long year with so many losses and sacrifices between the pandemic, the death of loved ones, a draining election, and a reckoning of systematic racism. I'm sure many of your Thanksgiving days will look different as a result. I know in our family, my younger sister and I just yesterday canceled our trip to Texas in light of the high numbers of infections and travelers this week. We were going to meet our nephew and see our older sister. The loss of this gathering felt like someone placing a heavy book in an already heavy backpack. Not only did I become aware of my grief in not being able to meet my nephew who was born in August or see my sister, but I became aware again of all the other weight that I've been carrying throughout this season. The other canceled plans, lost memories, and grief that's been weighing on me. Perhaps you all know the feeling. I have a feeling you do. I am beginning to see, however, that one of my lessons from this year is how feelings are not mutually exclusive. I can feel both joy and loss, faith and fear. I can hold hope and pain. While my faith does not dismiss or negate my sadness will also never outweigh my hope. Because God came to us and God remains with us. Because God loves us and walks alongside us. Because God reveals God's self in ordinary moments of beauty, kindness, peace, and even joy. There is always hope. It is for this hope that we give thanks. And here's the amazing thing about Thanksgiving. The more we give thanks, the more we are able to see what there is to give thanks for. It is an act of courage. It is an act of resilience. It is a surrendering to God. Thanksgiving transforms us, giving us new eyes to see how God is acting in our lives. In giving thanks, we peek behind the divine curtain and become aware of how our eternal God breaks into time and space to reveal God's promises, sustain our faith, and encourage a response from us. In Greek, the word for thanksgiving is Eucharistia, the same root of our word Eucharist, what we also call communion or the Lord's Supper. At our church, we believe that communion is a physical sign that demonstrates God's promises, sustains our weak faith, inspires love for God and love for neighbor, and allows us to see the ultimate reality of life, almost a fourth dimension, God's presence all around us, all the time. It connects us to God and each other and allows us to respond in gratitude. In time, it even changes our hearts to be more like Christ's. The thanksgiving and transformation offered through communion or Eucharist, however, is not a rigid, set thing that lives only within an hour on Sunday or during communion once a month or however often you partake of it. As Christians, we take the transformation of communion, of Eucharist, of thanksgiving with us as we walk through life. It is an attitude that gives us new eyes to see God's presence in the world. Thanksgiving inspires more thanksgiving. But giving thanks does not negate feelings of loss or pain. We can find God's presence amongst us and give thanks. And we can grieve. And we can be angry. And we can be tired. Give yourself permission to feel all these things this week. It does not have to be one or the other. And know that you are not alone. So for this last spiritual practice of coloring, I invite you to print one of the sheets attached to this email or Facebook post and reflect on all the good things that have revealed themselves this year. General things like health and food and shelter are certainly worth noting. But see if you can add some small, ordinary things in there too. The way your dog wakes you up in the morning, your neighbor who raked your yard, the opportunity to explore your creativity with newfound spare time, the walks you take in your local park or around the block. What signs has God given you that represent God's promises this year? How does God sustain your faith? And how can God's blessings encourage you to confess your commitment to God and to care for your neighbor? Remember that God is still present today and forever. And may God bless your Thanksgiving this year. Know that I am thankful for all of you.